وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. وبعد, today is Saturday and today's date is the 4th of Safar for the year 1435th of the Hijrah of the migration of our great beloved Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam, which coincides with the 7th of December for the year 2013. And Saturday is designated to study tafsir, the meanings of Al-Quran Al-Kareem. And we are studying and discussing Surah Ali Imran, Surah number 3. And before we proceed, you have and everyone must understand that one of the major missions of Al-Quran Al-Kareem and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is to correct the falsehood that the previous people attributed to the prophets of Allah Al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. Musa, especially Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, and especially Isa, Jesus alayhi salatu wa salam. That's why we find great abundance of information and discussion about those two magnificent messengers of Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala, Musa, Moses, and Isa alayhim salatu wa salam, especially Isa. Although Musa alayhi salatu wa salam is mentioned more than Isa in Al-Quran al-Kareem, Jesus, however, the correction is more about what the people falsely claimed Isa alayhi salatu wa salam to be. He is God, he is the son of God, he is one of three of one, and so on and so forth. And this will indicate, and the second mission of Al-Quran al-Kareem, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at first place to the people of the book, as Al-Quran al-Kareem stated this clearly. Yeah, why the people of the book before anyone else? Because as we said, they made many changes to their books, many lies against their prophets, many lies against Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. Still, they still have some glimpses of what? Of the truth. When you talk to them about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they understand, and they understand very well. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran al-Kareem in several places, O the people of the book, we have sent our messenger to you. And today, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, we are going to resume studying Surah Ali Imran and studying the story of Maryam, Mary alayhi salatu wa salam, and Isa alayhi salatu wa salam. And we stopped at verse last time, at verse 55, we finished this one, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ended verse 55 by saying, ثُمَّ إِلَيَّ مَرْجُعُكُمْ فَأَحْكُمُ بَيْنَكُمْ فِي مَا كُنْتُمْ فِيهِ تَخْتَلِفُونَ. Then to me, to Allah, the only true God, is your return, and I will judge between you concerning that in which you used to differ, especially about Isa, Jesus alayhi salatu wassalam. Quran al-Kareem says he is a human like any other human. He has a miracle birth. A miracle birth is defined that he was born from a woman without having any relationship with a man in any way, shape, form, or matter. Yeah? Allah created him inside that woman, and he was produced in a different way than the normal births of the rest of the humans. And this is easy to Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the miracle birth does not constitute that he is God, he is the son of God, or he is one of the three gods in any way, shape, or form. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what? All of you, are going to be returned to Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is the one who is going to chair to judge between you. So verse 56 says, and I quote, فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا فَأُعَذِّبُهُمْ فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا فَأُعَذِّبُهُمْ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَمَا لَهُمْ مِنْ نَاصِرِينَ وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ فَيُوَفِّيهِمْ أُجُورَهُمْ وَاللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الظَّالِمِينَ ذَلِكَ نَتْلُوهُ عَلَيْكَ مِنَ الْآيَاتِ وَالذِّكْرِ الْحَكِيمِ إِنَّ مَثَلَ عِيسَى عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ آدَمَ خَلَقَهُ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ قَالَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكَ فَلَا تَكُنْ مِنَ الْمُمْتَرِينَ Allah says, and as for those who disbelieved, I will punish them, I will punish them with a severe punishment in this world and the hereafter, and they will have no helpers. But as for those who believed and did righteous deeds, he will give them in full their rewards, and Allah does not like the wrongdoers, the zalim ones. This is what we recite to you, O Muhammad, of our verses, and the precise and wise, message Al-Quran Al-Kareem. Indeed, the example of Isa, Jesus, to Allah, is like that of Adam. He created him from dust, from dirt. Then he said to him, be, and he was. The truth is from your Lord, so do not be among the doubters. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us what? People are what? Are disputing and disagreeing what about Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Is this my daughter? No? Okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us those who disputed, disagreed about who is Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to judge between them in the hereafter. And he said, after he told us who is Isa, the story of Isa. He said, those who disbelieved in what I told them, who is Isa? Who is Isa? Which is a human like any other human. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him from one woman, not from man and woman. And he made him the messenger of Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he was never crucified, never killed, never died and then resurrected. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him up before such blood and conspiracy take place. So those who then disagreed about that, say, we do not agree with you, Allah. We believe that he is the Son of God, he is one of three, whatever they call it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them what? Kuffar. Disbelievers. Okay? Disbelievers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? After I told them who is Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, after I cleared everything for them in the Quran al-Kareem and through Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I am going to punish them in this life and the hereafter. And from the moment they start claiming that Isa alayhi salatu wasalam crucified and killed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent so many disbelievers, great disbelievers, to punish them in this life. They've been chased, tortured, this and that, since forever. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is punishing them. And the greatest punishment yeah, in this life, that they lost everything. Lost everything. America, the superpower, correct? And it is the dream of most of the people to be here, to live here. What is left for the Christians in this country? Nothing. Yeah? Look at what they are fighting for now. Anybody knows the two major things they are fighting for? What is the what? The second one? Yes, the second one, which is what? Huh? No, no, no. Abortion. Yeah. All what they have left to fight for, because they lost everything. Huh? Everything. What is left? Prayer in school, and what? Abortion. As if tomorrow, if the abortion is made illegal, the aborting will stop. Yeah, it doesn't make any sense. 8 years ago, there was what? The left of what? They just celebrated it. Two days ago.
Abolition?
The prohibition, yes.
Prohibition.
You are totally right. Yeah? What did the prohibition do to America? What is the major thing that produced in America after the prohibition? Organized crime, yes. You thought about it, you are right. Yeah. The organized crime. Before the prohibition, if you know your history, there was no such thing called, or maybe what was not known, or maybe was not organized, such thing called what? Organized crime. Yeah? Why the organized crime has been produced? Because the prohibition did not work, and the people, they wanted to drink alcoholic beverages, intoxicant, no matter what. So what is the second thing that was produced after the organized crime? The organized crime was to bring you the real, safe, alcoholic beverages. What was the other one, which is unsafe? Moonshine. You do not know your history. You are not very well. Moonshine. Anybody will know why they call it moonshine?
They used to cook it at night.
They used to cook it at night, waiting for the moon to be in the sky, so they go to the forest and cook it what? At night, so they will not be caught. Yeah? Will not be caught. So what they are fighting for now? Abortion, prayer in the school. Abortion, prayer in the school. Abortion, prayer in the school. Yeah? And created huge hypocrisy. Huh? Huge hypocrisy. For most of the people. يعني, regardless those who believed in the Old Testament and the Old Testament only, or both the Old Testament and New Testament. Yeah? Very clearly, yeah, in the Bible, Old Testament and New Testament, there are certain things called what? The rules, the governmental rules, yeah, especially for the crimes. Start from homosexuality to adultery to whatsoever. See, we can speak against them, those who are still speaking against them, but we cannot and we should not and we must not insinuate directly or indirectly that the punishment of God or the penalty of God should be applied to these crimes. Does it make sense? As some put it, it does if you do not think about it. Yeah? But once you start thinking about it, nothing. So here, nobody lost more, yeah, next to the Native Americans than what? The Christians. They have nothing left. Now just imagine if they cannot conduct a prayer in the school. And they are putting so much huge resources to gain it back. Every single day, someone is suing them for anything, any symbol that supposedly represents Christianity or other religion, but mainly Christianity. And they look for leftover here and there, And wallahi ya akhwa, the devout Christian, yeah, the devout Christian is the most mistreated in this country. Yeah, every law in this land, domestic, state or federal, is against what? Against them. Yeah, against them. They have nothing. Why? Because they believed in the falsehood. Why? Because the people are sick and tired of hearing that. They lost their customers long, long time ago. Yeah? In some Western countries, especially north, west of Europe, you do not find even people in the churches anymore. Yeah? Churches anymore. Instead of blaming the message, saying, well, what is wrong with us? Otherwise, why do you think what a place like America here needs all the machineries in the world to stay here, needs all the resources in the world to lift the pain and the suffering of the poor and the needy here, and they go looking for what? For customers somewhere else. Why? Why? Last statistic they had, some of this Christian organization, they said 94% of the Americans, they do not make it to the church. 94%. Yeah? So they lost their customers long time ago because it is not convincing anymore. And the pain they are suffering beyond imagination. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that. And he said, and also in the hereafter, and in the hereafter, and they will have no helpers. Yeah? Any helpers? Who's helping the Christians here in America? Yeah? The local laws? Are the local laws with them? They cannot open their mouths about saying, well, we need to make this law or that law compliant with the Bible. The Constitution was founded on the biblical Judaism, Christianity, this and that. Where? Just a claim. Because in their heads, anyone who says in his wordings God, then he is a believer and or religious. Never. Never. Because people, they believe that seculars, they do not believe in God. They do. But as they had it in their image. We believe in God, but God leave him alone, and now we'll do everything as we wish. We know better for ourselves than God. That is secularism. Does not mean that a secular person does not believe in God. He or she does. But they believe in God as a matter of creator and some aspects of worship. Other than that, he has to leave us alone. He has to leave what? Us alone. And they have no helpers whatsoever. No helpers. Who said so? Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he said what? But as for those who believed and did righteous deeds. Imam Tabari says, and I'm quoting, وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِكَ يَا عِيسَى صَدَّقُوكَ فَأَقَرُّوا بِنُبُوَّتِكَ وَبِمَا جِئْتَهُمْ بِهِ مِنَ الْحَقِّ مِنْ عِنْدِي وَدَانُوا بِالْإِسْلَامِ الَّذِي بَعَثْتُكَ بِهِ ودانوا بالإسلام الذي بعثتك به وعملوا بما فرضت من فرائضي على لسانك وشرعت من شرائعي وسننت من سنني. Says in regard to those who have, but as for those who believe and did righteous deeds, Who are those who believed? Those who, Imam al-Tabari says what? Those who believed in you, O Isa, Jesus. Those who believed you, those who believed in your prophethood, and those who believed with the haqqa that you brought to them from me. From me. And we told you so many times, there is no such thing called the Injil of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam anymore. It's not there. There are biographies about Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Yeah, four of them are accepted and most are rejected. But as a book, as a book of worship, of laws, it is gone long time ago. It is not there. Are there some quotes here and there in the New Testament about Isa alayhi salatu, from Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, Jesus? Yes. Like in any biography, when you write a biography of a person, you said what? And he said, and he did, on such and such date, on such and such place. This does not make it what? A book of worship and a book of what? Gathering. Because when we say, what is the definition of Al-Quran Al-Kareem? The definition of Al-Quran Al-Kareem, after we say the actual spoken words of Allah Al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala, we say what? It is a book of what? Of worship. And a book of what? Of gathering. A book of what? Of worship. And a book of what? Of gathering. Gathering what? Everything.
Governing.
Governing. Governing. And a book of what? Governing. A book of what? Of governing. From government. Governing. Governing what? Everything. If you are alone living in a desert and or deserted island, this Quran is your government. Look at you here. What is governing you, and made you come to al-masjid? Your faith in Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala, and what? In the book of Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the messenger who brought this book from Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. What made you reach into your pocket and pay your zakah? Anybody telling you what? It is now the 14th of what? Of April. Get ready to pay the zakah. Or because of your faith in Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the faith of Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Al-Quran al-Kareem is what? A book of worship, worshipping who? Worshipping Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. How? Based on the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nobody has a say in it. And what else? A book of governing. Governing who? The person, the family, the society, the community, the government, the world, the whole universe. The whole universe. We cannot say, well, worship is for Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. Government is for someone else. No. أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بَعْضِ No. So those who believed in Isa alayhi salatu wasalam and believed him, and they accepted and believed in his prophethood, and what haqq he brought, what truth he brought from me, from Allah, and those who practiced the religion of al-Islam that I commissioned you with. Because remember we told you, when the Hawariyun, the aides, the helpers of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, they said what? They said what? قال الحواريون نحن أنصار الله آمنا بالله واشهد بأننا مسلمون. And they told you what the word مسلمون is, what is the criterion word. واشهد بأننا ايش مسلمون. No prophet of Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala brought any religion other than the religion of Islam. What is the religion of Islam? Very simple. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, and أشهد that so and so of the messengers of Allah is the messenger of what? Of Allah. What does it mean? I worship none but Allah. How do I worship Allah? Through that messenger whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to me. Not bil ahwa'i wal bid'ah. Not by lust and or innovations. That simple. Yeah? So all of them, they were what? They brought Islam. And all of them, they were Muslims. And he said, what? And those who practice the obligations that I made obligatory on your tongue, and the laws that I gave to you, and the sunan that I gave to you. Gave to you. Those, us. Those who are still believing in Isa alayhi salatu wassalam, only the Muslims who believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam to be the last and the final messenger, and they do not accept anything in any way, shape or form except what comes from what? From Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam directly, and was practiced by him and by as-sahaba al-kiram under his teachings and supervision, radiyallahu anhu. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we believe in Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Nobody under the sun, past, present or future, believe more in Isa alayhi salatu wasalam in the only right way except the Muslims of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nobody. Nobody. And we believe to be him about, he is the messenger of Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu said, what this? But as for those who believed and did righteous deeds, he will give them in full their rewards. And Allah does not like the zalimun. The zalim ones. Zalim one in this context, al-mushrikun. الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا عِيسَى إِلَهًا مَعَ اللَّهِ أو قالوا بنبوته لله أو قالوا أنه الله مستقلا أو قالوا ثالث ثلاثة وإن الشرك يا بني لا تشرك بالله إن الشرك لظلم عظيم. Oh my son, do not associate a partner with Allah. Indeed, associating partner with Allah is the great the great injustice. Because what is dhulm? To take the rights of the others without any right. So the right of worship belongs to who? Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. The right of godship belongs to who? Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. The right of lordship belongs to who? Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you say something or someone is God or part of God in any way, shape or form, then you are what? Making him equal to who? Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah said what? Wallahu la yuhibbu al-zalimeen, and Allah does not love those who what? Those who commit dhulm, and the greatest dhulm is shirk. قولوا قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم فاستغفروه سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. The class is over inshallah. If you have any questions, corrections and or concerns, we'll entertain them in the remaining time. This is I do not see it or it's gone. The clock.
Oh yeah, it's gone.
Okay. تفضل حبيبي.
When the Christian of Najran came to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, was it year 9 or 10th Hijra, and they debated with the Prophet. At that time, the Bible was considered false or...
Okay, it's an excellent question. And let me rephrase, forget about the context you put it. During the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was there any genuine, authentic, unchanged, untampered with Torah? There's a question. And the answer, indeed, yes. there was. And many, 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 many scholars of these days, they think if the Vatican allows access to their archives, most likely they're going to find one of these covers there. I'm talking about Torah now. خليني بس أجيك حبيبي.
من سورة البقرة وكيف يحكمونك وعندهم التوراة فيها هدى ونور. So we know it was genuine.
About the same thing is mentioned about the Injil. Okay. قال فأتوا بالتوراة فأتوا في الإنجيل.
No.
Okay. So the same, but just واحدة واحدة شوي. The Torah, for sure, no ifs, ands or buts about it. The Yahud who were around Al-Madinah and in Al-Madinah, some of them, I'm trying to be extremely precise in my expression, they used to have a genuine Torah. Genuine Torah has nothing to do with the one we have now. Okay? That's why many Jews nowadays here, they do not believe in the Old Testament, they believe only in the five books of Moses in the Old Testament. Clear, akhi? Now, about the Injil of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Were there any evidence from Al-Quran al-Kareem or the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam? Yeah? When I mean that was available and one can touch it, see it, bring it and do this. Okay? Because when the Torah, as we read in Sunan Abi Dawood, was brought to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took a pillow like this, put it down, and he took the Torah and put it here, and said, what amantu biki wa billadhi anzalaki. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took it to in his hand, place it, and said, what I believed in you and in the one who what sent you down. So for the Torah, we know that in some quarters around Al-Madinah and inside Al-Madinah, they used to be there. And we know that Abdullah ibn Salam, when he accepted Islam, we know that he used to have one of those what authentic, unchanged, unmatched virgins. Clear? Is there anything about Al-Injil suggests that there was something available as in what? In the Torah? To the best of my knowledge, there is no such evidence. No such evidence. People, they ask why? Because you know, Habibi, after basically 300 years from the ascension of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, the tampering got in full what? On full what scale? However, are we sure that from among the Bibles that were circulated there, many of them, many of them until this very second, in total support, and I'm not talking about the Injil of Barnaba, the Injil of Barnaba, mainly it is falsification. Okay? Most of it is tampered with. Yeah? Now, the other Bibles, which they call them the lost what? Not Bibles. The lost Gospels. The lost Gospels, many of them until this very second, and as I told you, the HBO, if you want to go on the internet, they have produced something called The Secrets of the Bible. I advise each and everyone to listen to them and not to listen to the two Muslim scholars they involved with them. Got it? Stephen? Okay. See? Those lost books, and if you put them all together, every piece of information in the Quran al-Kareem about Isa alayhi salatu wassalam is supported by such a thing.
So I took it that what you are saying, that when those Christians came to the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam and they debated and ayat al-mubahala qul ta'alu nad'uwa,
they did not want to debate, they were challenged to debate, but they did not.
But the Nabi alayhi salatu wassalam, did he believe at that time that the Bible that they were carrying is not genuine and is not? I mean,
because Habib, the story of the story of Najran, the great majority of the information about it is fabrications. The only information, authentic information about them, it's basically just the visit and the offer of what? The debate, and they refused, and then they asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to send with them Amin, to teach them the Quran and the Sunnah, and he said with them what? Abu Ubaidah, Amir ibn al-Jarrah. The information that you read in the Sirah and Sirah ibn Ishaq and these things, including that when their Salah came and they wanted to pray to the East and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam allowed them to conduct the Salah in his masjid, these are all fabrications.
Is there anything in Sahih al-Bukhari about this?
Very little information.
Now,
well, it's with regard to this, but let me tell you this. There is no indication, there is no indication whatsoever that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam believed that they had what? The Injil of Isa. The Injil of Isa, the Injil of Isa, since forever, basically, and I'm just using it, these things, no Christian, I'm talking about my information now. I can be wrong, there is no need to debate it. No Christian believe that there is an Injil of Isa. Only quotes from Isa. But the actual book, I do not know that anybody claimed that. Okay, but the Torah, yes, but the Injil, I do not know of any information.
The Torah was written in Babylon, which means that after what is the time gap between Musa alayhi salam and the extradition of the Jews to Babylon, right? I mean, don't you agree that the Torah was written in Babylon?
See, no, I do not agree. Because the Habibi, when you study comparative religion and the history of religion, you have to basically anything historical, you have to take it and what? What do you do with it? Throw it. Because it is basically, it is like archaeology. Archaeology. Until yesterday, they told us, well, the human chain was coming from one route, correct? Now they found another bone, they conducted the DNA. Hey, there is another humans, they were running with what? The other humans. Yeah? So, when we speak about religion, unless we have solid information from the Quran al-Kareem and or the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have to dismiss. Okay? To dismiss it, inshallah. Anything else? Done? جزاكم الله خير سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك وانت كل ايه شو اسمه